throughout the season, it's difficult for me not to want and see perfection, not only in the things that I do, but in the things that we do. So I want the sermons that I preach through Advent to be perfect. You don't have to say anything. I want the decorations to stay and not fall. We lost a wreath one year to the wind outside. I want the poinsettias not to dry up in the heat of the building. I want to be sure all the candles will light and that we remember to light them. I came in this evening and began to make ready our sanctuary and had the lights on, and I came to turn on the lights on the Christmas tree, and I hit the switch. No light. Felt like Clark Griswold out on his yard. I didn't kick any poinsettias. I didn't throw a fit. So surely I'm missing something. I was. It just wasn't plugged in. When you seek for perfection, it's easy to jump to conclusions and miss what is right in front of you. Sometimes we do that. Yet we come tonight and we hear the stories, the prophecy of Isaiah, the words of Matthew, the words of Luke, the angel appearing to Joseph, the angel appearing to Mary. We can picture in our mind's eye Mary and Joseph traveling to Bethlehem. She great with child. I always picture her, I don't know about you, but she has a blue robe, a light garment on, maybe a white scarf over her head, riding on a donkey. I don't know if Luke says anything about riding on a donkey in the Bethlehem, but I've got Mary riding a donkey. And they journey into Bethlehem. I suspect that's not exactly how they imagined the birth of their firstborn son happening. They got into Bethlehem. There was no room for them in the inn. No room for them anywhere except this little cave-like structure, a barn, a shed, something under a cliff, whatever it was. There with the other animals amid some straw, Jesus was born. And laid not in a beautifully prepared nursery, but a manger, a feeding trough for animals. And if I listen closely to the words, I'm reminded it doesn't have to be perfect, because God works through our imperfections most of all. I suspect like you, or like me, you want much of this season to be perfect as well. You look for the perfect wrapping for that gift, for that perfect someone. It has to be this for your niece, your nephew, your granddaughter, or your spouse. You look for the perfect gift. You want the tree in the right place with the ornaments on the right side of the tree. It's always that one that just won't turn the right way. It always turns the other way. Maybe if we hear the story, and maybe if we listen to the words that are recorded for us in Scripture, we can hear more clearly that God is not so much interested in our perfection as God is interested in being in our hearts. Anne Weems has written a book entitled Kneeling in Bethlehem. It's a collection of meditations and devotions, and in one of those she writes, in each heart lies a Bethlehem, an inn where we must ultimately answer whether there is room or not So this Advent, let's go to Bethlehem and see the thing that the Lord has made known to us. In the midst of shopping sprees, let's ponder in our hearts the gift of gifts. Through the tinsel, let's look for the gift of the Christmas star. This Advent, let's go to Bethlehem and find our kneeling places. I think Anna is talking about home. Home. Tonight we gather in this place and we worship the one who had no home in which to be born. The one whose parents placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in a guest house in a strange town. The one whose parents listened and watched with amazement as stories from shepherds were told of angels appearing out in the fields, proclaiming good news.